restoring and rebuilding this deck has been, I know I always say this, but it's one of my favorite projects so far, because as you can see, I've got the best seat in the house. No, we just love it. It's our own little backyard oasis now. And I love sitting out here and watching this man in this pool. He's the new pool boy, I guess you could say, pool man. He's 6'2", but watching him and this baby and all our kids out here in this pool from our deck has been amazing. But it wasn't always that way. If you haven't seen any of our other videos, when we bought this place, it was a mess. It was so nasty. It was full of garbage, trash, and there was no back deck. And it's so pretty out here. Not in these pictures, but it is. It's got trees on two of the three sides for views out here. But it was a mess. My dad is a mechanic, but he also does excavating. And Diesel does it with him. He's been on these machines since he was probably 2 or 3. That's him running a full-size track hoe at 12. He's 13 now. But we burned and buried what we could, and we hauled off what we couldn't, and they got this yard looking amazing. They cleared it out. It's this big old yard. They leveled it out. And then our friend and neighbor and ex-client, Miss Susan, gave us this deck. Y'all, this deck is huge. I want to say the rectangle part is 10 foot by 30 foot. So she said, as long as we come and get it, we can have it. So we assembled a team, mainly Diesel and his friends, and Aaron and Michelle, and Dad, and Savannah and Abby. There's my daddy, y'all. So he got his friend Patrick to bring his flatbed and tow it to the house. Even these, it was a round pool, so they had these two ends that went around the circle pool, but our pool was rectangle, but that was fine because we can use those pieces for other areas. But we had to haul it in three separate pieces, really. So we did the two circle ends by themselves, and then the two big ends, the two big rectangle pieces. So then the process began of jacking it up, getting it attached to the house, getting it level, putting new legs underneath of it. I mean, this was the longest part of the whole process. Just making sure it didn't fall apart, you know, jacking it up little by little. See, we got it propped up with bricks and everything, and but we had to get it level, get it attached to the house, and then put the legs underneath of it. It was just a really long process. And at first I was scared. I was looking at it and I'm like, oh my goodness, this thing's gonna fall apart when we walk on it. But it didn't. I mean, Aaron did a wonderful job. I mean, he's a carpenter by trade. He used to build houses from the ground up, plumbing, electrical, everything. I had full confidence in his abilities. I was just worried about getting this deck put back together because Miss Susan said, you know, they've had it for like 20 years. They were just going to tear it down and burn it. And I said, you know, maybe we can salvage it. Well, we ended up, they took good care of it because we only had to replace, you know, just a handful of boards, like 6 or 7 boards, I think. It wasn't very much at all that we had to replace. This deck was an absolute blessing because we are not rich by any means whatsoever. And I'm a penny pincher. I like to bargain shop, as you can see from my other videos. I like finding the deals, and wood, even though it's come down quite a bit, it's still pricey. And to build this deck would have cost us a fortune. So instead, all we had to do was replace a few boards. And then my first time walking out on there, because I always wanted to get this deck out here. I wanted to get a deck where I could walk out here in the mornings and drink my coffee and just look at the beauty that is out here, because these trees are so beautiful. It's like I have a privacy fence of trees. Like, it's so beautiful out here. And this yard is huge, but I couldn't enjoy it because I couldn't walk outside, you know, without walking around the whole trailer. But now, like, this deck was coming together and I was getting so excited. And then we had, we put Grace in this baby pool, just, you know, until the big pool got here, because he's spoiled rotten and we're obsessed with him. Anyways, so then this deck, it started coming together. As you can see, the wood was old. It needed to be washed and brightened. You know, there was a huge contrast between the two, the old and the new wood. So then Kathy's husband, Tim, brought his power washer out. And y'all, I didn't even realize how dirty the actual trailer was. I was focusing on the deck. And then I walked outside and he showed me where he had started power washing. I'm like, oh my goodness. You know, and then I just got mesmerized by watching this. I mean, I don't know. Are any of y'all like this? I could sit here and watch this for days. It's so mesmerizing just watching it go back and forth, and watching it just rip that nasty mildew or mold or whatever that is right off of the house. So Tim finished power washing the house and started power washing the deck, but I bought this deck cleaner. It's supposed to, you're supposed to let it sit for, I think it was 15, 20 minutes, and it's supposed to clean and brighten and restore old decks. And it worked, y'all. It worked like amazingly. So I just rolled it on there with a roller. I let it set. And it started even eating away at the pan that I had it in. And look at that. That wood looks practically brand new. And here we go again with watching the power washer. I just love it. Like, I could just sit and watch this all day. So for those of you that are, I don't know, OCD, I don't know what it is that makes this so fascinating to watch this, here you go. So I worked through the night because it was so hot during the day already. It was getting so hot. It was like 103 heat index, 110 one day. But I got it done. We let it dry for a few days, and look at there. Like, you could barely tell the difference. I mean, up close, you can't tell as much in here as you could up close in real life. You could still see the contrast, but that's where they started digging out, leveling out for the pool. But then we had all this extra wood over here because we're eventually going to wrap this deck all the way around the pool. There's going to be a little walkway all the way around the pool. So we have extra wood, but then I took some wood filler and I filled in the big cracks and the old parts. And some where those knots had popped out, I filled that in. Then I went in and sanded it all down, and that was not fun with carpal tunnel, let me tell you. I don't know if any of y'all have carpal tunnel. I have a lot of autoimmune issues. Carpal tunnel is a big one, and it sucks because I'm very crafty. I like to do things myself, and it's really hard when your hands are cramping all the time. But I love it, so I do it anyways. So I had to sweep it off really good in 100 degree temperatures. And look, the sun was going down and it was still so hot and muggy out here. Like, I was dying out here sweeping this porch. This is the southern heat for you. This is Tennessee weather. This was early June, I think. Or no, it may have been the end of May. End of May or beginning of June. And it was so freaking hot already. It was so hot. But I got it done, got it swept. And then I went to Lowe's. Now, this was kind of pricey. It was like $45, I think, for this gallon. But it was awesome. It was a semi-transparent and the color was reindeer. But it was, you know, one coat. It was a one coat stain and I don't know. It was like a 2-in-1. And when I was putting it on there, I noticed that it made the old wood. The old wood soaked it up real quick. So it was a very visible contrast. They blended better before I put the stain on. So what I ended up doing was putting 3 coats on the new wood and I think I did 2 coats on the old wood just for added protection. And this little thing that I got from Lowe's for stain, it's for deck stains, it sucked. It didn't even last through the first coat. So I ended up having to get a roller. What I wanted was this really fluffy one that I had saw on several YouTube videos, but Lowe's was out. So if you can see this thing that I'm using, do not use it. Do not get it. See, look, not even halfway through and I already had to switch to a roller. But this was after, I don't know if that was the first or the second coat, but you can still kind of see the difference. Not so much in this video, but real life, like I said, you could really see the difference. So that's when I ended up putting the 3 coats on the new one. And I think it ended up being 2. But then, look, it blended perfectly. Like, you cannot tell. When you walk on my porch, you cannot tell the difference. So then I wanted a gazebo, but they were outrageously expensive. I mean, I wanted like a 10 by 13. And, well, with this deck, it ended up being like 8 by 12 or something like that. Because the house, the roof stood out a little bit. But once again, Aaron is a carpenter, so we just used what we had. I mean, I bought some 4x4s, but these, instead of getting 2x6s, because they were ridiculous, we improvised and used some of the extra deck planks that we had because they were like 1x6. And then he ended up just doubling them up to make them thicker. And then I got these exterior screws. He leveled it out, marked it where it goes, and then put those little plates to hold it. Now, mind you, I know some of y'all carpenters may be watching this. We are not done. We have temporary braces on like the corners at the top. We're actually gonna start back working on that, but we're gonna put the blocks, these blocks around the base. See these in the corner here? These are just temporary. We're gonna put pretty ones. We're gonna make it pretty on all corners. And then we're actually gonna attach it to the house and put like fence. Because if the babies come out during the winter time, I don't want them to be able to get into the pool. And then Kathy found this sheet metal on Facebook for $50. And there was, I think, 13 pieces. And there's the heat, see? 100 to 110 heat index. It was ridiculous. We did most of this work at night. Plus, Aaron worked during the day. And so he would only come here in the evenings or on the weekends anyways. But it was way too hot during the day. So I had this vision in my head of what I wanted to do with this. So we got this sheet metal. I looked everywhere and then Kathy found it. Oh, and this little handle on this spray paint, y'all. I think it was like $6 at Lowe's. And it is worth it. Especially if you have carpal tunnel. Because I went through, I think it was 8 cans of the spray paint. So I just got the flat black in that Rust-Oleum and it's rust resistant and it's outdoor paint or indoor or outdoor. And we just coated them real good. Now, mind you, this is the underneath. This is the part that we can see. The top, I actually didn't paint that because I'm going to get some heavy-duty stuff for the top. And it's the kind, it's the stuff you just roll on. I can't remember the name of it. But that's our next thing. If we ever get back to this project, we have a ton of projects going at once. Erin made these rafters or joists or whatever. I went and bought some 2x4s. And those little brackets holding them up, I just got the cheap ones and spray painted them black as well. So it would be pretty. But isn't that pretty? Like, it was coming together. I was so excited. I actually laid those up there during the day just so I could see what they look like. I laid them up there myself. That was not easy. I'm short. It was hard getting them up there. This neat little thing came from Lowe's. It was Memorial Day when I got that. It was a Memorial Day sale. It was like $130 or $140 bucks, something like that. But, oh, and then look at this. This baby deer just comes strolling through our backyard. Now, we live in town, so this was unusual to see. But he just came strolling through. We were on the back deck, me and Savannah, my daughter, and Grayson, my grandbaby. And I was like, oh gosh, there's dogs over there. Don't go over there. And sure enough, he goes over there and the dogs spot him and took off under. The reason I muted it is because we were screaming, but he did escape. We chased off the dogs. The dogs did not get him. He escaped into the woods on the other side. But this is what we did. So we put the pool up, I think it was 3 feet from the deck, because we knew the pool wasn't going to be tall enough. So we wanted a step down because we wanted to go directly from outside or from inside the house, outside and into the pool and then have the walk around. So Erin made another deck. You know, that part we have done. We don't have the walk around completely done. I mean, that's the next process. Like, we have a lot of projects going at once, but it's just baby steps. We just do a little bit at a time, but we do have that part of the deck finished. Then I got these mosquito screens on Amazon. Y'all, Amazon literally has everything. I'll link those below, but they were really cheap. And then I got the curtains. I just bought 3 panels because I didn't need one for, you know, against the house. That would have been a waste of money. So I bought 3 separate panels. And then this little thing, y'all, this is a privacy screen. Because see those houses over there? I wanted to have privacy for when we're swimming or for having a lady swim. I don't know, I'm really modest like that, I guess. I don't like people watching me when I swim. So that screen was $89. We got 3 of them to cover that whole side. So when we get the deck built around the pool, we'll have that too. And this hammock. I love this hammock. Look, Abby, I secretly recorded her trying to get out of it because it was hilarious. Pregnant woman trying to get out of the hammock. But that hammock, oh, I love it. I also got that from Amazon. I will link that below as well. But look at this. So then, like, the sun, it comes down and it was still shining. So I'm able to move these curtains wherever I want them. So they're blocking the sun as well. And then I got this neat little thing. So this projector was like $90. It was cheap, and I ended up getting this mosquito repellent too. But that projector just connects to my laptop. You know, some of them have Bluetooth capability. I didn't need that. All I needed was to hook my laptop to it. I didn't want to hook my phone to it because I use my phone. But look, I got this little patio set from Walmart. And these little things I probably got from Marshall's, or that candle came from the dollar store, Dollar General. But Marshall's, all these plants I get from Lowe's. I rescue them from Lowe's. Most of them are like $1. You know, if you go back on that little clearance rack and that little pink plant holder, I think I got from Marshall's too, or maybe it was Ross. Same thing, that's actually a cake stand. But I thought it was cute, so I put my plant on it. And then there's this open area I'm gonna get, eventually get like the little cafe table and chairs. But look at this, these lights also came from Amazon. I'll link them below. I love it. I just love it. I love being able to walk out here. And then check this out. So that privacy screen doubles as our projector screen. And that fan, oh my gosh. I got a set of two and I only needed one of those fans from Amazon. And the pool lights I also got from Amazon. Love it. You can set them on timers, but I don't because I feel like it runs the battery down. But just look at this. I love it, y'all. This, we live out here basically. Like, I would sleep out here if I wasn't scared of snakes because we are in Tennessee. And some of y'all have been asking for more of Blake, and I'm going to try to convince him to be on camera more. I sneak and record him, as you can see in some of the videos. He's hilarious. He is my best friend and my soulmate, and he will be making more appearances in the future. Y'all can check us out on TikTok, Meet the Priors, and you can see some of his craziness. It's hilarious. But until then, here is the playlist of our mobile home makeovers, and we hope you have a beautiful, blessed day.